Hi, I'm Dr. Darakul, sleep medicine physician and neurologist at Bumrungrad International Hospital. I have been treating people to getting better sleep for more than 10 years. Sleep disorders refers to the condition that affect timing, duration, or sleep quality and affect a person's ability to properly function during the day. The common sleep disorders ranging from insomnia, restless leg syndrome, narcolepsy, snoring, or obstructive sleep apnea, or OSA. OSA is one of the most common sleep disorders. So it occurs during the night because of the upper airway collapse and your brain get not enough oxygen. The common signs and symptoms of OSA include snoring or being told that you have a process of breathing during the night, waking up, sudden awakening at night, feeling gasping or choking for air, having frequent nighttime urination, having morning or nighttime headache, feel tired all day, feel fatigue and sleepy during the day after enough hours of sleep, having cognitive impairment like forgetfulness and concentration problems, and depressions. This is all signs of sleep apnea that you should see the doctor. Factors that may contribute to higher risk of sleep apnea include male gender. However, women aged over 50 or being menopause women have equal risk of men to have OSA. Having family history of OSA, being obese or overweight. OSA frequently coexist, but usually undiagnosed in these conditions. If you have high blood pressure and diabetes, you're at 25% chance of having OSA. In stroke patients, there are 70 to 90% chance of having OSA. In people with coronary artery heart disease, epilepsy, and Parkinson's disease, you are at 30 to 70% risk of having sleep apnea. So untreated sleep apnea can cause a bunch of consequences. It leads to drowsy driving and car accident. Also memory problem and increased risk of medical problems like high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, stroke, and heart attacks. It also can increase the risk of Alzheimer's disease and increase the risk of some cancers and sexual dysfunction. Sleep tests, also called polysomnogram or PSG, it's a test that done overnight. So we monitor your sleep problems so we can diagnose sleep disorders. It can be done here at the hospital or at the hotel or at home. And usually the sleep specialist will review your study in the morning after and plan the treatment. Treatment here is very impressive, especially for sleep apnea. The CPAP machine or continuous positive airway pressure is the machine that act like an air stent, increase the airflow to stent the airway open so the brain can get the oxygen the body needs and the brain can sleep better. Also, the CPAP not also can reduce the symptoms, but also can help prevent medical problems in the future, like heart attacks and stroke. So not getting enough quality sleep may reflect that you may have some kind of sleep disorders, especially sleep apnea. And this can affect every aspect of your life, including health, your mental health, the work or school performances, relationships, and cause more medical problems. However, the treatment can reduce the symptoms and reduce risk of medical problems, as I mentioned. Because we want to give you a good night's sleep, a good health, and don't forget that health starts with good sleep.